Hey Mixer, how you guys doing tonight? Welcome to Module Mashup, our new kind of learn to play. We decided to go and take the Module Mashup in a more community-driven direction for you guys. So you will learn to play D&D, ask all of your questions here in chat, and we will do our best to answer them. We're also going to kind of explain our thought process on our turns a little bit more. But before we get all the way into that, let's bring in, how you doing, Deluxe? Let's bring in our players, our new DM, and we will get ahead. Gonna explain everything. Hi, players and DM.
Hi, Sev.
Hello.
Hi, Sev.
Hello.
Hi, Sev.
We as a group have decided to take this in a more community-driven approach. Now, for Josh here, Spartans, I'm getting feedback. So for Josh here, who is a newer DM, he's got some nerves, but at the same point, as we're teaching you guys how to be players at a table, because he's a newer DM, he's also going to be learning to DM at the same time. He might have questions, we have questions for him or me, on how to DM a game, how to handle a situation. The two of us will go ahead and answer those questions as well. That being said, for the players, most of us are going to explain our kind of thought process on turns, which, you know, there might be a couple different options of what to do. You know, explain abilities if you have questions. Explain our classes if you have questions about those. I mean, basically, the questions are open to anything D&D related. And we'll do our best to, as a group, kind of explain or give you any guidance going forward. So, Josh, as I remember, we left off on a cliffhanger with the other DM, Epi. And now you're here. So the last thing I remember is Noman launched a Silvari at a fleeing giant.
Yes. So time just starts unfreezing again as we get back into this. As the rest of you off to the sidelines, you know, Godshield, Jin, and M, just watching as Noman, riding Axie the Axebeak, tosses Silvari at the fire giant. And Silvari, the fire giant was holding the plot device that I was looking through so many notes and I couldn't find the name of. And you knock it to the ground. The fire giant just sees this and just looks at the dire situation that he's now in, and he automatically flees. So you save the plot device, and the fire giant runs. And that is the end of that.
And people say never to toss an elf.
Usually the opposite way around.
No one tosses the gnome.
Even better is the fact that Silvari has boots of wing boots.
Yep, I remember that.
The giant flung the gnome.
Yes, the gnome did. And then he died.
Do what?
And then he died. So, Silvari, you're flying back towards us just as we get to that point?
With the plot device, hopefully.
Yes. Plot device in tow, you fly back easily.
Alright, so I Noman, the gnome barbarian, known as Noman the Barbarian, riding his trusty axe beak that he was able to charm mid-battle. Thanks, Epi! And rides over to the rest of the group, you know, rears it back wearing his deer skull helmet, and is like, who the hell are all of you?
I'm
Abel.
That's the same.
I'm Im. That's nice to meet you. What's your name?
He just stares at M, and then to Jin, and back to M, and to Jin. And he walks He walks over to, what's your character again, Craig? I don't see his token.
Abel.
Walks over to Abel and, like, tugs on your robes.
Yes.
There's, don't freak out, but there's two demons here.
They're with, or with me at least.
He motions you down.
Yeah.
What's your AC?
Seen because of the 16.
So 16?
Mage armor.
Okay. Josh, I'd like to rage.
Okay. You're raging.
19. So I slap you as hard as I can across the face, trying to break you out of whatever charm spell they put on you.
You send him, like, over here, near the tree. Is that strength?
Oh. Looks back.
Demons.
He walks over to M. Do you have a tail?
Yeah.
Points to the horns. Sorry. Then literally grabs the tail.
Okay, you can make a contested, like, another strength.
Okay. So athletics. Well, it's an athletics, right? Because it's a grapple.
Yeah, athletics versus his athletics plus acrobatics.
24.
24.
I believe. Come on, tail. Nope.
I lift her up by the tail and see, look, horns, tail. Pretty demon-like.
I'm not a demon. I'm a paladin.
It's a bit more comical because this person who's like half your height is lifting you up with ease.
Catherine starts. I am slightly suspicious.
Stand up, start brushing the...
Hey, boy. Are you alright?
Yes.
Damn, the charm still worked. He looks, he grabs his sword, puts M down. Swings it around wildly, not at anyone.
What's his intelligence?
Not as high as it is in Pharrell. His intelligence is a solid 10.
Okay, alright, yeah.
Noman's intelligence of Pharrell is like a 17, by the way.
Oh, God.
The guy is super smart. He just plays an idiot.
It's okay. They're friendly.
Friendly demons.
She really
paladin demons. I've heard everything now. He sits down and starts pulling out ale.
Head over to the NPCs.
Yeah. Yeah, two of them are stabilized on the ground. One of them's like, "Woo! I survived!"
Oh, yes. Yes!
Well, that is an interesting.
So, sorry. Chat... That is a appropriate accent for a African American NPC, which I thought it was going to be Spartans that got us banned off Mixer, but was I wrong? It was Josh.
You never expected.
I did not expect it. No, not at all. Chef, if you're out there, I apologize. Don't beat my ass at PAX East.
Don't. Not mine either.
Okay, he is watching eight.
I think he is in chat, yeah.
Is he? Hi, Chef.
Granted, she was arguably the MVP NPC in that fight with that bow, man.
Oh, yeah.
The Giant Slayer.
Yep, the Giant Slayer ability. Oh, God. Continue.
So what are you doing, Albert?
I don't want to go back to purple. I like blue.
All y'all doing that, Catherine's going to Savari, make sure he's alright, if you did just get thrown.
Surprisingly, I am not as injured as I thought I would be after being thrown at a giant.
What's your best? I said, looking at his hand.
Yeah, what is it, Josh? What is this plot device?
I told you, I went through so many notes and I couldn't find it.
It's like right at the beginning of this chapter.
Is it?
Yeah. Where it says the giants go to dig up this.
Always the last.
So another tip to all those prospective DMs out there, when you're running a module, read.
I did read. I just didn't find the one thing I needed.
Jin stares.
You just skip some words. It's okay.
Jin stares at Silvari, who's apparently carrying a white outlined box with a question mark on it.
Hasn't spawned in on Mario yet.
What could it be?
I'm sorry, okay?
Noman's hoping for the raccoon tail. He wants to be able to spin around and jump.
Roll me a d10 to see what item you get from the item box.
Oh god.
No, you're not.
Net one.
You get a blue shell.
Oh god.
I would like to use the blue shell immediately.
Okay.
I throw it down, and because we're in a race, and the giant that is running away is technically in the lead, that shit will hit 100% of the time. Do not turn this to me. Do not turn this into Mario Kart. I am evil in Mario Kart. I will hit the brakes to use a blue shell.
Okay, alright, that was the joke. So what are you guys gonna do now? There's two unconscious NPCs and one doing a victory lap.
Go ahead, Jet.
Does anyone know how to wake these people up? I know I'm not doing my accent no more, so forget it.
Oh, but Jen!
Gotta do your accent!
Oh, Lord.
We're already gonna get banned. I'm not gonna purse. Well, we're already gonna get banned, so might as well, really.
Purse me.
Hold on. Find it again. Give me a
time. Noman stands on a...
says Jet!
Noman stands on a dead body and high fives. Urgalith, which does our victory a lot.
Oh, high five! She high fives you.
Shiny man swats her on the rump as she runs fast.
I'm sorry. I'm exactly so funny. Save.
11. Noman does not murder her.
Em, do you have any healing left?
I do. I have a bit and one for my healing book.
What do you have on your healing? What do you have in your laying hands?
I have one.
Yeah, wake one of them up with the one.
Yep. Over and wake up Marth.
Okay. Wake up Marth, who's now at one. He coughs a bit, looking really weak, beaten up. He was on the front lines.
Hi. Sorry. All the giants are gone, though. She'll help them up.
She kind of looks around. Oh, the giants, yes. Kind of, like, rubs his forehead a bit. Yeah, they hurt. I get the feeling they weren't supposed to be attacking us and mainly focusing on getting whatever they wanted.
Looks to Silvari at that, and, like, Noman and the others. They seem to be really wanting to attack us for a bit there.
Noman stares directly into the counter. Thanks, Epi.
I would have done the same mistake, okay? Anyways.
By the way, half the town seems to be on fire.
He kind of turns around. Help, please?
Anyone got a bucket?
Part of the bucket brigade.
Yeah, I meant...
Let's go!
Roll me perception.
Put out the fires.
Yeah, you just put. You put out the fires after
the,
some
no,
time.
Noman turns into the all gnomish fire brigade, riding Axie, and just carries around buckets and does the wee woo sound the entire time. I will roll the performance because I'm okay with this. That's a 7.
Silvari will actually work with Noman and splash the buckets of water over the tops of the fires.
Sev, it's less of a wee-woo and woo-wee. You're not getting quite right.
Hey, you know what? They haven't started it yet, so therefore I've set the trend.
There you go. Silvari helps out.
Yeah, you're getting it, Silvari. You're not sure what Noman's trying.
Looks like fun, whatever it is. It's better than being attacked by giants.
So, you guys are putting out the fire with Wolfstar still stabilized on the ground. He eventually wakes up.
I mean, M's the healer, so I mean, we're kind of, you know, letting her do her thing. She's the first ambulance. You know, we have Silvari and Noman, the first firefighters, and Abel Catherine and Jin can be the cops that are standing back. Hey, Dad, stay back. This is a crime scene.
Argulich just like tries to break through. Let me through. I can help.
Just point a sword at the pedestrian square directly.
Fried chicken.
Sir.
Oh Lord, please no.
y'all just let me through here.
Wait, no, ma'am.
What?
Get the zip.
Mira, save me. Please.
She just walks away, like, stomping her feet. Just grumbling, like, I didn't sign up for this. I saved the city.
I don't know if you're trying to go southern now, but, like, I should warn you, Josh. Like, half of the server is southern.
Yeah, I know.
You may want to tread carefully.
Don't kill me. I know. Like, Jen, Mira, Nazgul. Yeah, I'm safe from him.
I think
Osri is here. Osri will tell Nasi just so that he comes at you.
Yeah.
I got. I'll probably get you from here.
I'm in hiding. None of you know where I am.
I do.
Oh yeah, you do, don't you? Yeah.
For just $9.99, you too can know Josh's location.
What a deal! Locations. I think Mira would pay that, would she? Yeah, I can see the crackling of knuckles now.
Yep, look at that. There they go.
Hey guys, look over there. There's something else to do. That doesn't involve a southern accent.
Now, Mira, that also comes with specific instructions on how to murder someone when they're offline, in terms of on the server. It's a very specific rule set we play by. So you know, you get those as well. I mean, you just sleep in the room with her. Cool, she says. So, fires are out?
Yes. Dars, I'm pretty sure, eventually wakes up because stabilization.
Yeah, I think I said she had healing too, so.
So, Nars and Dars are literally just laying back, leaning against one of the many destroyed buildings or burnt, put out buildings, just looking tired, and then Olga is just like sitting with them. So.
Oh my god. We actually got a donation. For $9.99. Oh, this sounds like a deal. But wait, there's more, says Fallen One.
Fallen, no.
Fallen, wait for that DM. It'll be coming.
Oh, yahoo! The worst part is, you can easily figure out where I am, Seth, even if you don't know it yet.
I already know where you are. You told me. It's in the DMs.
I told you. I can figure this out later. Anyways. Yeah, so the three of them are just sitting down, just talking. Olga, obviously a bit more high hopes than the other two, who are, you know, very, very much hurt.
Mm-hmm. So these buildings that were on fire over here, I have a very specific question. They are farms, from the looks of it, right?
From the looks of it, yeah.
Okay, because the Fs that I see. Oh, I'm still in as a DM, aren't I? I am. Let me change that. I would like to go ahead and search for a chicken coop. I'll settle for a pig pen.
Okay, roll me.
You have to give me 1 second to roll yourself.
Okay, yeah, no, I'm just thinking about. Roll me perception and investigation.
Okay. Gnomon's two greatest skills as a barbarian. Oh, do you get assigned, Sev Gnomon Sheet, please?
Oh, I haven't? Okay, hold on.
No, I haven't, because I was in his DM.
Yeah, hold on.
Last time.
People are okay, and the fires are out. Em's gonna go pick up her javelins.
There you go. Should, you
which, didn't you throw them where the fire was?
Yeah.
So the javelins, I do not see any of them.
Oh yeah, hold on. It's being players' journals, too. There you go.
Okay. I also need Axie.
Yep. Give me a second.
All right. Perception and investigation.
Okay. Let me see.
That's a 6 perception and a natural 20 investigation.
Okay. So this is going to get a bit odd.
Do you have your rolls whispered, Seth?
No. It just popped up right now.
Okay. Yep. Must be lag then.
So, you don't find anything of you're looking for, but you do find several anthills on your natural 20 investigation. You know, they're just untouched by everything that just happened here. You don't know how.
I'm gonna look at Axie, and I'm gonna start digging out the antholes to feed him the ants.
Okay. He's now eating ants.
I need to feed him. I mean, seriously, that's why I was like, chicken coops. I was like, oh, these people are probably dead.
Can Silvari assist him so that he gets his advantage on both rolls?
You know what? Sure. You find not one, not two, but 2.5 chicken coops.
Another half. I let Axie go ham.
Yeah. Roll me a d10 to see how many he gets before they all run off.
Three.
So out of like, we'll say 30. That's a good amount. You know, that can give you some money. He gets like 10 before they all run off, and he can barely get any more from there.
So I'm in. I'm letting him eat them. I'm not taking them. I'm letting him chow down. He's a meat eater.
I mean, I don't think any corp is gonna, you know, get mad at you eating their chicken. So on you.
You'd think that, but this is how ghosts are made.
All of a sudden, we're being haunted for the rest of the adventure.
I mean, I come with ancestral guardians, so I mean, you know, I'm used to ghosts.
Yeah, they're in the chickens as well as the owners of the chickens are now part of your ancestral spirit group.
I'm down.
Don't give him this power. It will just grow as we continue on the campaign.
Yes, no, it's too late. DM had death decreed.
They're just flavor. They don't do anything extra.
We're good. No, there's gonna be. You don't understand. You don't have to deal with it when he goes into battle. All of a sudden, there's like 17 berserkers, a chicken, a bird, an axe beak.
That's a couple of farmers.
Couple of farmers. Some of the giants that he's killed. Anything else he manages to murder on the way? We're going.
Josh, I would like to spend my last rage for the day.
Okay.
And all my ancestral guardians, including the chickens and the farmer, show up, and no one just starts talking to them. Sitting down around while they talk to the NPCs. No one's talking to ghosts.
Okay, roll me a persuasion. Just...
Aww.
Let's see. Roll me a persuasion.
It's an 11.
Yeah, the chickens make great conversation. Turns out when they're ghosts, they can actually speak to you.
Sweet. I apologize, but I told them, you know, Axie has a life to live.
Yeah, they're okay with it. You know, they didn't have anyone else to take care of them anymore. One of them in particular, like, asked if he could eat Lenny the chicken.
I take a description of Lenny, and I now have a sworn enemy. I will find Lenny the chicken, and I will eat him.
Congratulations, you can add Lenny the chicken to your enemy, Seth.
I am. I am doing this right now. On stream.
You see... Okay, let's go back. Oh god, okay. So, Em, what are you doing?
People are healed, fires are out. She's checking on the party to see if they need any healing.
Okay. Albie, what are you doing? Say again, you cut off horribly.
Are you talking about me?
Yes, I'm talking about your character. I can't pronounce things. Or
it's okay. Just going around trying to help anybody that's displaced from their homes.
Yeah, you find like a few NPCs that aren't like token. You know, thanking you for the help you give them. Jin, what are you doing? Sparks.
Sparks is not here right now. Store. He's currently going out the store. Probably.
Okay.
Or he's falling asleep.
Godshield, what are you doing?
She's going around, like, talking to, you know, not just the NPCs of Far West, but, you know, citizens of the town in general. And you see a very, very nurturing side you never really expected from the barbarian Godshield. Especially for people whose house has been destroyed, homes were destroyed.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so as you all are doing this, Sev, someone interrupts your ghost talk for a bit.
Okay.
It's Olga. I'm just gonna call her Olga.
Okay, Olga.
You know, she walks up to you and says, you know, that fine spirit you have, I'm not gonna bother doing any more accents because I'm not consistent with them.
Thank you so much. Thank you. First off, I'd like to thank God for answering my prayers. And it would not be possible without his love and support. And secondly, I'd like to thank all of you in Mixer who threatened to beat up, throw shoes, and otherwise cause bodily harm to Josh. Continue.
Thanks, guys. Thank you. I try my best. Okay, sorry. Excuse me. So, she remembers, like, having an adventuring companion. She was an adventurer back in the day, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It was very much noticeable with how the fact she didn't manage to fall down like many of the others.
Yeah, definitely noticeable. Not by Noman, though, because Noman was on the other side of the battlefield. But continue.
But one of her old acquaintances had a... What weapon does Noman use again?
Noman right uses a longsword.
Longsword.
Because he's a gnome. He can't use anything heavy.
Okay. So, she recalls one of her former adventuring companions, Harthos, having a... It was a great sword. I'm sorry. But it was a great sword. Called a giant slayer great sword.
Noman's eyebrows raise. His eyes go wide. And he starts to salivate. Continue.
Okay. Last time she spoke with him, he was living in Zymorven Hall, ancestral keep in Ravenwood? Ravenwood, northeast of Silvery Moon. And Olga over there thinks Harthos would be willing to part with the weapon if they properly explained their reasoning to him.
Can you just give me the names? Yeah.
Names? Okay.
Northeast of Silvery Moon.
Ancestral Hall something.
That's the name of the adventurer. He's a wealthy knight.
And the place is two places.
Yes, hold on. Somewhere Hall and not actually with that last couple letters. This one. Which is northwest of
Northwest, okay, east.
Yeah, north. Northwest of Silvery Man. Is that good?
Yep, thank you very much.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're used to that. Firefly's a player.
So that's the question you get you here, Noman.
Noman jots all this down.
What does he jot it down on?
He's got an arm and a quill.
You know what? I like your style, Noman. I like you.
Also, I have one other thing I'd like to ask. So I have tinker's tools and a kazoo. Right? So I'm not going to use the kazoo here because I don't think that anyone's spirits need to be cheered up. We have like half the party doing that already. So can I use my tinkerer's tools to, Axie would have made a mess, can I make a cape out of the feathers of all the chickens?
You can certainly try.
That's a 20.
You know, the chickens from your ancestral spirit, despite you probably not raging anymore by this point, but they watch you. They still watch you like appear like and watch in awe as you turn what was once their bodies and feathers into a magnificent chicken cape.
All right, I am now in a deer helmet and a chicken cape. Noman is playing directly to his strengths.
You can add chicken cape to your items.
Thank you.
Oh, okay.
Cape of tribe war chickens.
Are you sure you're not possessed?
No one just looks over to the way. No, I am. Did you not see all the ghosts?
Alrighty.
So, while you're going around doing your healing, you know, Narth walks up to you.
Oh, hello.
You know, a few months ago, the Iron Shield, a place called the Iron Shield Coaster, received a place from one Amrath Molbar. He begins just telling you the story, because, you know, he sees you healing and he feels he should share this information with you, right?
Mm-hmm.
Actually, yeah. With one Amrath Molbar, yeah, that might be how you pronounce it, which is a Castilian of Noner's Hold, and I'll give you the names after I finish saying everything, okay?
Okay.
So, for five horse harnesses made by none other than Tribor's finest harness maker, Osevir. He recently finished the last of his harnesses, and Narth needs to arrange for the delivery to Nonar's Hold since the recent giant attack. He's worried about the safe arrival of the shipments, and Narth, he hasn't been to Nonar's Hold, but he tells you it's this village near the High Forest that once attracted a lot of wealthy hunters. Okay? So you see, he like leads you over to this area, right? He gestures for you to follow him. Do you follow him?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, he leads you to this, like, where the few harnesses are, and in a large crate with the Lion Shield coaster emblem painted on the sides. And he asks you and your party, because he's seen you do this good deed and seeing you're all capable, to do the delivery for him. Do you accept?
I, of course, would need to speak it over, talk it over with the rest of my party. I don't foresee it being an issue. She gets out a piece of paper. Can you mark down where it was?
Yeah. He tells you exactly how to get to Nonar's Hold by following the Evermore Way. Okay. It's ready for when you want to do that one. He tells you you don't have to do it immediately, but it's just ready for when you do want to do it.
All right. Thank you very much. I'll have to talk it over with the rest of the party and see when they would like to do it.
Cool. All right. He gives, you know, a nod and goes back to helping how he can despite being a bit wounded.
Names, please.
Yes, thank you. One moment, por favor.
So what is everyone else doing while he is typing out names? Since we have no questions in the chat currently.
I mean,
checking out the box.
Yeah.
He tells you it just has harnesses in it.
No, they're talking about the mystery box, which I'll log in over here and get it for you.
Thank you. I couldn't find it. I'm serious. I'm sorry.
Mira and Dilix are raising their hand. What's your questions?
Yeah, type out your questions. Mm-hmm. And we'll answer them in the downtime when he's typing or other than that. And all the players here currently have chat open, so if questions directly to you, you guys can address it.
Parvo, what was the mission? Something about horse bridles? We're delivering them to somewhere for some way.
Yeah, Nornar's Hold. For money. How do I feel about not having rage left, Noman? It's, I mean, Barbarian Rage is is never good not to have. But we do have two barbarians, so in a situation, I can rely on Catherine in this party to pop a rage. So I mean, really, we have kind of two tanks, so it does, you know, play to our benefits.
All right, those are all the unit names on there.
Thank you.
God Shield. So you told me you're doing this nurturing side of everyone of your character, right? You know, doesn't pull this out often. You know, sees the situation, just feels a bit bleak. Yeah.
Yep. Sounds right.
It's the Vonadin fragment.
There you go, Vonadin fragment, guys. Thumbs up.
Can you spell that?
I can. It'd be a history check to know what it actually is.
I guess.
I'm at a 22.
I'll try.
Do you want me just to read it since I know where it is?
Please.
All right, so thousands of years ago, giants and dragons fought a great battle here, during which the giants unleashed an enormous dragon-slaying construct called the Vonadad. Part of the construct broke off and was embedded in the ground. Over time, this fragment became buried in the earth deep today. Today, it lies under the campground in the heart of the town, Area T2. So the area where they were digging, kind of where Jin is right now on the map. That's what you would know about it. You don't know why they're after it. I mean, other than the fact that it's, you know, culturally important to them, because we don't know about the Sundering yet. That's or the
Ordning.
The Ordning, that's what it is. Thank you, Fallen.
I'll find out in time then. Okay.
Okay. Josh,
I do have a question before you start back up. I do have a question for you from the chat.
Mm.
All right. So Mira asks, now that Josh has stopped the attempted to make a southern accent, what accent will you attempt next?
Whatever I feel like, okay? Leave me alone. I want to voice that.
Listen, Deluxe is calling for Irish. Can we get an attempt at Irish?
Okay, hold on, give me a second. Fair to laugh your socks off at my horribleness.
I want to hear some Chinese or Korean.
I can't do that.
Listen, people make fun of Irish people all the time and don't get in trouble for it. I'm behind this. Being Irish.
People make fun of Chinese people all the time, too.
Yeah, but they get in trouble for that shit.
Time of the morning to you, laddies. Okay, I'm not doing
not
that
terrible.
Again. No, I'm not doing that again.
Azuri's calling for Jamaican.
Jamaica man.
Okay. So now back on to your story. Thank you.
Exactly. Anyway. So, where was I? Right. This one. So... Darnus just looks at you, Godshield, just helping the others. And he just gets reminded of an old acquaintance that he recently visited. A merchant from Mirabar. I'm being honest, that's actually how you
say it. That's actually how you spell it? No, that's how you say it.
So a merchant from Mirabar. Oof, and he had an interesting story to tell you. The merchant saw a dwarf clean the stables in Exandral's Keep. Which is a fortified village on the long road. He later recognized him from a wanted poster he saw from doing traveling south through Long Saddle. The merchant is sure the dwarf he saw is the wanted brigand, known as the Weevil. According to the wanted poster, whoever delivers him alive to the authorities in Mirabar can collect a reward of 5,000 gold. He kind of, like, thought about going after Weevil himself, but you kind of look at him up and down, and he admits it himself. He's getting kind of old for this stuff. So he figured, like, giving this information to the people who just helped save his small village would, you know, be a bit more rewarding.
It seems very useful. Be a nice little dirt.
So... And that's his quest.
Let's write that all down. So.
Yep, I'll start putting the names down.
No one looks around, seeing that these NPCs that fought all had quests. And he walks up to, I mean, the only two people that look like they are casters are M and Abilify, correct?
Yes.
He looks to you. Which of you can speak to the dead?
I'm sorry?
Can you speak to the dead?
It goes to look. No.
Shakes head.
Sighs. If only we had a cleric.
Yeah, that would have been. That's actually really smart stuff.
Just gonna start talking to the dead NPC corpses.
No, you just ask him. All right, what's your quest? They just steal everything.
So, I thought I misheard you, but no, that's the weevil. So, mirror bar is where we have to deliver him. Xanathar's keeper is where we find him.
Xarathal's. We're not going to Xanathar's. I do not want to fight a criminal underground beholder in Waterdeep. No, thank you. That's way off the beaten path.
We'll get to it, TM.
Will we now?
But Mirror's where we're delivering the Weevil to. He's in Zathar's keep, which is on the Long Road, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
There's a place called Long Saddle, which I think is a village.
You, no. When he saw the wanted poster when he was traveling through Long Saddle.
That's where he saw the wanted poster. We probably could, he's from Mirabar, we could probably bring him to Long Saddle, based on there's a wanted poster there, since I think Long Saddle's closer.
Okay, I don't know the geography of this place exactly yet.
You don't, so.
I don't either.
I'm fine.
I tried looking at the map, I didn't understand them. Oh, jeez. Okay, so... So, it seems like you guys just overall finished like your rounds through the village. Seems like things, despite how bleak they may look, will probably eventually just get back to it. So what are you guys gonna do now? I imagine Noman would have told about his quest. I imagine Em would have told about her quest. I imagine Conchild would have told about their quest.
Here's your map.
Oh, there's so much. Is there lore about all these places?
This is the north. This is the Sword Coast.
It's so pretty.
This is only a small bit of the actual world.
Really?
Yeah. So the Tomb of Annihilation is not even on here. It's very far south. It's like way south.
So where are we?
We are at Tribor. Yep. So if you look at...
Okay.
Right here.
Okay.
If you look up, you see Long Saddle, and if you look a bit higher than that, you see Xanathar's Keep and Mirabar.
Okay, so if we follow the road up that way, we could get to it.
So yeah, so we have... So we're going a long bit to Xanathar's Keep. Our other place is way up here, at Silvery Moon, Zervan Hall. Do we have a road? No, there's no road that connects Zalthar's to there, unfortunately.
But could we go up?
Where was the last one?
Do you mean the one about Mirabar?
No, Mirabar was we had to go to the... Mirabar's not on this map. Mirabar's on
north.
Mirabar's up here. It's above Zarathar's Keep.
Right, oh, okay, it's right there. Sorry, I was thinking Mirabar. Oh no, it's Luskin. There's Luskin. Okay, well, it's in line from Luskin.
What was the one that we did the horse breath?
Yeah, where was yours, Firefly? What was the name of yours?
Mine was. Hold on.
Iron Shield.
Yeah, Nornar's Hold. Lionhold Cluster. That's over to the right here, next to the Calling Horns.
Okay, right there. So, all right. So just so you guys, so we had started, so to talk to chat here for a minute. We had started chat. Thank you for the follow, Deluxe. And welcome to the Yay! Guild. Just so you know, so the Lost Mines of Anellon, the 5e starter adventure, takes place here. So basically, the only things we had seen was in here, this part of the map. So now that we're in actual modules, you can see how much bigger this area is that we're traveling about. So all of so the entire module that you guys were playing before takes place like in this box.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is this like a map that we all have that we could mark stuff on if we wanted to?
This is our northern map. I would say that we, if we want to mark stuff, I'm okay with it. Because there's this other map here. There's there's one that just has players on the map where you're traveling. I like using this as a DM, just because I'm not. I mean, you guys are native to the realms. The chances that you've seen and know where some places are, I mean, it's okay. If we don't know, like, say there was the Shadowtop Cathedral, right? Say this was a thing that we didn't know about at all. We just would have to find out about it. As long as we can all keep our metagaming in line, I have no problem with us using this map.
Okay. Oh, by the way, I should have mentioned, Narth offers 100 gold for the delivery, and you can keep Boris in the cart after you complete delivery, so it's fast, so yeah.
Oh, so we also get a cart.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big... So Noman Leah looks about the party, still eyes jumping between the tieflings. I'm sorry, but Noman is racist to tieflings. I kept that
I'm used to it.
I need to let my dog outside. You guys can.
We'll have a little talk. It's fine. Noman, yeah, looking at the map that these, you know, this we put down. I'd say I put one map down for the group, right? Yeah. He points out the fact that, well, we want a cart, right? So is it best to go to Dun Nornor's? We get the cart, and then from where we are, maybe head up to Zamrun Hall, and then come back down around to go to Zothos to get the quest done. I mean, because we don't know that there's another main story quest, right, available yet.
Right.
Mixer just sent me notifications. Thanks, Mixer, for vibrating.
That was impressive.
Deluxe, thank you for following.
I already called it. You're light falling.
And which one's the one delivering getting the sword?
The sword was up at Zarmond Hall. It's on that road after Silvery Moon.
Alright. Yeah.
It just seems if we're going in Enner's Hold, I mean we can go off road. I'm not against going that coastal route here, but I'm not sure that it's going off the road here, in the Evermoors is worth avoiding the road back. Especially since we have cart and horses. And that could take us longer. You are still allowed to say it, Fallen. Yeah, the vibration from the phone, yeah. So, that's my vote. My vote's... There's two on one path and one on the other. I mean, or we go do Zarn's Hold... And then we come back and pick up the horse. I just don't want to take the... Noman wouldn't want to take the horse and carriage if we're going to have to come back to the town. Test received.
I have to agree with Noman. Hold.
Agreed. Thank you. I was going to say that as well.
When Josh is back, I have one more question for him, which comes into our actual decision making, because we know that the two quests together don't really have a time limit. Or if the other one does, we should probably do that one first. It's the one thing we just didn't ask.
Because that one hunted someone down.
He did say he was in a hurry.
He was in a hurry. Yeah, then we probably should do that one first. So yeah, we'll head out to Long Saddle in the morning. And then from Long Saddle, we'll go to the keep to look for him.
No, I mean, what's the harnesses? He was worried about that.
No, but he's not in a hurry. He said it's just available for whenever you can do it.
Oh, okay. that I misheard.
So it's that's 100 miles. That's 1-to-1.
Okay. The harness is a sword ain't going to go no. But hunting down a wanted fugitive, you know, he may end up on the other side. The freaking, what's this called? The West Marches?
We cannot hear you, Firefly. That is correct. I feel like Spartans also took a nap.
I'm back.
Josh, question for you. Just to make sure that we heard you correctly. So when you were talking about the Weevil.
The Weevil, yeah.
You said he was in a hurry, correct?
Let's double check wording.
We're basically just we're deciding between our two routes.
Okay.
And this is what for us will make the most difference.
Mm-hmm. He didn't say anything about him being in a hurry. He said he saw the dwarf known as the Weevil traveling when he was traveling through Long Saddle.
Okay. And he's in Long Saddle or is he in Zarthurski?
Okay. The merchant saw a dwarf cleaning his stables in Exant Falls Keep.
Okay.
And he saw the wanted poster in Long Saddle.
Got you.
Okay.
I would still, I mean, the bounty's high. I mean, not you know, thinking about this in a real. So this is the world that we're not knowing that they're not happening, right? Like, if it's a 5,000 gold bounty, people are going to be looking for him. So I would say that we go there actually first.
Some big bucks.
It's big bucks, big bounty hunters, right? Best case scenario, you know, we get there. I mean, we got to bring him to Mirabar. Travel to Zothar's Keep is about 200 miles along the road.
Okay.
So that's about a week.
A week of travel, okay.
It's broken, so it's like 4 days to Long Saddle, 3 days to Zathras.
Okay.
Are we all in agreement we go for the money first and then come back and do the two at once?
Show me the money!
Yes.
Is the bounty, he said the bounty specifically mentioned said he has to be alive, right? Or did he say dead or alive?
Well, we can go to Long Saddle too and double check the bounty and get a copy for ourselves. Because we're going to need it. Yeah, just go in to assault some guy in the stables.
We don't even know why.
You've got a monk, you're good.
Knowing why would also help. No, we will not take the cart because we'd have to come back through Tribor to go deliver it. And we don't want to take, I mean, at least Noman is against taking advantage of the guy. By leaving for a week with his cart and saddles. Alright.
As nice as it would be to try to log a body back with a cart and carry it, but...
No one pats Axie.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Alright, I'm down for this plan.
So, Josh, we'd like to take the night in the inn, which is already paid for.
Yes, please arrest.
To get our long rest and then head out to Long Saddle, 4 days to Long Saddle.
Okay.
Along
we
the.
We heard Firefly.
We did.
Oh, you heard me?
Huh? Yes.
Huh? Awesome, I have no idea what happened.
Okay. I do have to ask, more out of curiosity reason, because I don't know your characters well enough. Are you guys doing anything before you head to bed or right after you wake up? /
Are there healing potions for sale?
Are there? I paid attention to the quests. I don't think there are. No. It's a destroyed town. I don't think there would be. I'm sorry.
A lot of them would have been to keep people alive.
Yeah,
usually in the campaigns for AL, it ends up coming down to anything 49 gold or cheaper.
Yeah, and potions are generally 50 gold.
Exactly.
That's funny.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
We could... if you mention this, M would say we could try and stop at the nearest town and ask for potions.
Yeah, Long Saddle's later. On the way.
Yeah.
I mean, basically, on this quest, we're going Long Saddle might have them. The Keep might have them, depending on how we're treated. But Mirabar is a big town, so we'll be able to stock up in Mirabar. Compared to these other ones, I think Silvery Moon's a decent sized town, but I don't remember. So this at least is going to get us to a place where we have potential for stocking up.
Right.
What would it be to roll to see, like, if these people like tieflings, or they like elves, or they don't
that'd be,
like other
That'd beings? Be an insight check, in my opinion.
Okay. She's talking about a different town.
Oh, different town. I saw you talking about the people here. Sorry.
No. I mean the people, the places that we're going to visit. Like, if there would be people that it's generally known that this town like hates tieflings. No one should ever go there on pain of death, or barbarians. They hate them or something.
I think that'd be a history check.
Okay, I'll try.
Goes to open up. No, it's.
Puts him on the back.
I was kind of hoping he would roll low just so he wouldn't have to go through the notes.
No.
Yeah.
Of course not. I root for my players.
Thank you. I root for you.
Thank you.
There's an expression we use down here. Because this is a PG-13 stream.
Liar, liar, pants on fire.
Sure, we can use that.
That would burn.
Reading what they have here, yeah, I think they'd be personally examine Soul's Keep. I imagine you'd do examine Soul's Keep first, or would you Longstrider first?
Longsaddle first.
Longsaddle first, because that's the one we're immediately going to.
Okay.
She was just more looking for, like, races that they disdain for, races they do like, things like that.
I'm gonna say they deal with them like they would any other tiefling, you know, like, a tad bit of caution, but overall, you know, they're not gonna shoot you on sight or be racist, openly racist to you. That's what you would get from Long Saddle, I think, from what I'm reading here.
Distrusting, but not... not, we're going to burn you at the stake.
Yes.
Oh, good.
Which takes extra long because you're a tiefling.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay. So Noman's going to look for, like, a barn or something. And he's going to sleep with Axie because he doesn't trust people not killing the Axe Peak. Nor does he trust Axie not to go randomly murder someone in the night.
Okay. You find a barn with, like, an open roof from being destroyed. It's nice. Stars are nice. You know, it's a full moon tonight, actually. So.
He's a barbarian, so he's good with us.
Accepted. Reluctantly.
So.
Is there anything else you guys do throughout the
night?
That's
all Norman would do.
Alright.
Food and bath.
Em would probably get some food, clean off the worst of it, do her prayers, and get ready for in the morning, hopefully.
Yeah, I think...
Okay, I'm sorry I couldn't hear you. My dog was trying to scratch the scar. Sorry?
Oh, I was just saying that Em would get some food in her, say her, like, nightly prayers, get ready for in the morning. She'd double-check to see if anybody needed help or anything before she went to bed.
No, people are just trying to get back on track, you know, the ones that are alive. They're currently fine, and they'd insist that you get some rest yourself, you help fight him off.
She follows Ilda, I believe.
I still don't know God.
Well, that is the god of what, Firefly?
Life, nature. Neutral good.
That's nice.
Her symbol is a waterfall plunging into a steel pool.
Nice.
Thank you. Yeah, they... They see your that what god you follow. They're like, again, we thank you for everything you've done, the healing you've offered. Please get some rest. You know, they just basically tell you that. You've done a lot for them, both fighting off these giants and healing them. They want you to get some rest.
I'm glad to help. She'll go on up.
Okay. Next. Oh, yeah, God Shield, you're next.
Yeah, she'll just, once the evening comes, once the night comes, she'll spend even drinking, laughing, cheer you up in the tavern, then we're going to bed.
Yeah, you know,
not really the praying type, but she'll say a quick thank you to Helm for helping her out.
He appreciates that. You know, drinking, that some of these people, you know, they do come here in the night just to drink a bit. There's not much left to drink with all that's happened, but there is, you know, enough to have, like, a nice night. People are still trying to be merry, drinking a bit of their sorrows away. You have a good time overall before you head to bed. Craig, your character.
Nothing special. Just bed, say goodnight to my wife and child, and then just bed, and then go to sleep.
All right. So, morning passes. You all get a long rest, spell slots, rages, etc. And what do you all do in the morning?
I would get up. She'd go do her morning prayers, her rituals, make sure everything feels okay for the day, and she'd head on down for breakfast. She'd turn around to see if anybody else made it down.
I say kick open the door. I open it forcefully. Say, oh boy, that was the best sleep I've had in a while.
An actual bed does do wonders.
And comes and stomps downstairs. Sword in her belt, shield in her arm. Ready.
Prepare spells for the day and then go downstairs.
Colin, your character?
Savari would probably have been up well before dawn, at least a little bit before dawn, and just got some breakfast and was reading, keeping to himself, relaxing a little bit before everybody else starts coming in.
And last, but certainly the most boisterous, Noman.
Ah, how dare you. So, I would like to be up just before sunrise.
Okay.
And I would like to go hunting in the morning for food.
Okay.
And as an outlander, it's here somewhere. I can find food and fresh water for myself and up to 5 other people. So I'd like to come back, you know, with some rabbits, some even probably small game this close to the city, and some fresh water.
All right, yeah, that's fine. You come in with that.
I'm back to the barn, really. And he's, you know, skinning the rabbits to have a nice meal before they set out with the rest of the party.
Yeah, actually, you do find the chicken that you're looking for.
Already? That's such easy. I look to him, and I slowly skin everything else first, just staring and telling, let me get here. Hold on, no, you told me I found him.
Yeah, you found him, but I'm saying, like, he's getting ready to run.
Oh, okay. Oh.
Yeah, roll me an athletics check right now to see if you can catch him.
I would like to rage. This is my ancestral enemy.
All right. 18. You know what? I'm gonna whisper this.
That's fine.
Is it slash W? I'm pretty sure it's slash W.
Slash W, your name.
Okay. You know, I'm just kidding. Yeah, I'm gonna whisper this to you specifically. So.
Okay.
I'm gonna just roll. I'll tell you what I'm rolling now. I'm rolling a straight d20. Okay.
Okay.
Ah, hold on. There you go. Perfect.
That is definitely a straight d20. Brackets on either side, Josh.
I know. I forget. Okay.
Fun.
I actually hope it gets a 12.
I hope so too. Ah!
That's an 11.
Yeah. You feel like you're about to lose him, but you jump, grab him, and then you can add any more flavor from there if you'd like.
Alright, so Noman chases him down, like a kitten chasing a mouse, as she pounces on him. Or he pounces on him, sorry. I'm literally holding kitten right now. Pounces on him, grabs him literally by the neck, like he does that whole comical thing you see with someone grabbing a chicken in a cartoon. The neck goes up, the eyes bulge out, and he goes, Lenny the chicken.
He clucks.
I need oil. And he starts walking away with him. I would like to find oil in the city because I need oil. I need breadcrumbs or anything like that. I'm turning him into some fried chicken. I am making him into KFC, as was the plan. The second you told me I had an ancestral enemy of a chicken.
Yeah. Okay. Roll me. Okay, so roll me a survival, perception, investigation, and yeah, that'll be it. That's performance, not perception.
Oh, it was performance. Do you want my modifier is literally 3 less. But I'll roll it again. 14.
Okay. You're above average rolls make up for the survival, I'll say. As when you were hunting, you found just a bit of oil. It's not much, nothing you could you could do anything with except cook the cook fried chicken with. What else were you looking for?
Breadcrumbs. Like as you at this point, it's basically. Like older stale bread that you turn into breadcrumbs. And yes, I roll performance because Chef has taught us that cooking can be a performance. So I'm keeping that 20 performance roll.
Okay,
stick
fine,
it, Azuri.
You're keeping that for when I ask you to roll wisdom for cooking. you can easily find breadcrumbs. When you go to the tavern, you can literally just ask them, he'll...
Noman walks in, grabs all the stale bread, plops down a gold, I'll take it off my sheet, and walks out. Says nothing.
You all just watch this happen?
He never gave his name, did he?
No, I never did. You never asked for his name, Firefly.
I did.
No, you didn't. Noman would have responded to you.
She
dun,
did.
Dun, dun, dun. Then no one's a deck. Put Snoop.
When is this deck?
So you all watch him just do what he did of grab all the stale bread and place the gold and walk out.
Hello.
He's already gone. He beelined. He's got a chick. He's got an ancestral. He's carrying the chicken around, and has an armful of bread.
Well, he has a new pet. That's wonderful.
So my question in the tavern sitting around. My question, what are we going to do with the fragment? Do we leave it here? It does belong to the town.
Do with the what now?
The fragment.
Of the Xenothrones that was used to slay dragons.
It is pretty heavy, by the way.
I don't know.
Cart? We could put it on it, maybe, but they also might come after it again.
If we leave it for the town, then most likely somebody will end up coming back for it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If we leave it here, they'll just come back town around again. Although if we bring it with us, we risk it them coming back us around, or at least trying to. Are we all willing to accept that? Or, yeah.
When you say heavy, how heavy are you talking?
I'll get it. It's big. It's big and made out of stone or metal. So heavy. Silvari probably struggled to bring it back to us.
Yeah. I think so. I saw the name finally, but it doesn't link to anything else. So I can't tell you anything more. Otherwise, I would have told you, dang it.
Fortunately, Silvari was flying, so it made it a little bit easier. A little more leverage to swing it.
If we do take it with us, there's always the chance something else might want it. Now, if we had somebody who speaks giant, we could talk to them. Ask them why they want it so badly.
You'd be like that guy right there.
Yes!
Yes, I know it. I mean, I'll ask them, but... Yeah. We have to talk to the giants. I'd rather just smack them around.
I'd rather not run into them again.
I get this strange feeling that we will.
Don't you want to know what's going on?
What are the weighs 1,000 pounds.
Oh.
If you scroll down, one of the giants holds a rod of vaunted, which guides the air. We don't know that part. A bent and broken band of 2-inch thick, adamantine, roughly 11 feet long and weighing 1,000 pounds. Also, interesting note in the DM's thing, if you get the giants to 81 hit points, they immediately flee. Thanks, Abby.
Thanks.
If they get the giants to what?
81 hit points. They immediately flee. We played hard mode. It's fine, guys. We did much better than was expected, and we did well. So good. We got XP for it.
Yes, you got a lot of XP, I think.
Yeah, I still remember the last time I actually did the adventure, and we ended up holding the gate against 3 giants and 2 direwolves.
Oh, you played one of the easy ones with the gates.
We chose the hardest.
We chose the hardest.
Well, we didn't have a choice.
Oh, gotcha. So,
it ended up being 2 barbarians, like 1 fighter and 2 spellcasters and a cleric. And I was like, this is not going to go well.
I have input, but my character's not there, so.
Okay.
If you seek out Noman, he'll give you his input.
Silvari will seek out Noman because Noman is Noman.
At this point, M would preach the thing like, do we take the new person that showed up? I mean, he fought with us. See if he wants to go. I mean, I know he gave us the quest and everything.
He seems to rather like chicken. Chicken's always delicious.
He's got that axe.
So, who's going to follow Noman?
Silvari did.
Okay. Anyone else?
Catherine will.
I suppose, if we're all going.
So, Josh, may I take the scene from here?
Yeah, I had something in mind, but yeah, go right ahead. You do better.
So Noman has arrived back in his barn hideout, known as the Gnome Cave. And, you know, Axie is sitting there munching on some of the other rabbits and stuff that found. In there sits, like, a large, like, piece of, like, the plate armor of a giant, which he is using as a, which he has started to heat and poured the oil into. That is my walk. Yes. I'm straight up going walk. We're going chef style. He draws and etches 2 like, arrows, next to each other. And he somehow found in one of the houses, I'm going here, Josh, it's not anything big, a chef's hat.
Mm-hmm.
And, he welcomes everyone to Chef Noman's house.
Roll.
And he begins to prepare Larry the Ancestral Chicken as I get something here. Fallen. Roll. 1-1-1-1-1. Blame that beak because that beak. Did you really just make it uneven? Oh. Oh.
Several.
Oh, no, 999. No, wait, you did make it uneven. Fallen, I don't know what to do with you. It's 10.
No.
Looks at Sev? Yes, yes.
Roll me a survival for the cooking.
Okay. Channeling my inner chef Rob, do I get advantage on the roll?
I got the
mixer hat on. I have the mixer symbol on the walk. I have Mixy the Walker. I mean, there's no mixers back in the Middle Ages.
You know what, Sev? Why the hell am I not sure? You have advantage from the story you told me.
It's a 17.
Yeah. So he prepares the food. And whenever, like, he served all the food, like, you don't know where he got the plates from, but he served it with flourishes. Like, he does spins, you know. At one point, he, like, launches the food in the air, catches it, and then just, like, gently sets the plate down for M.
I would also like to point out the fact that I may have fried this chicken alive full. So, it was an ancestral enemy. You heard the screams of Larry the Chicken. Has fallen, probably did it again to even it up. Like, Chef Rob cooks for the party before they leave, and it's like a hero's feast, but no combat. So, I perfectly put that one in front. You know, serve up, you know. It's almost like the scene from Monster Hunter, but Noman playing the role of Cat. So. Place down. He has silverware. You don't know where from.
Who is going to try the chicken first?
Sure.
Yeah, you guys taste it, and it's remarkably delicious. Yeah, it wasn't gutted, was it, Sev?
I would think if he's not serving the whole chicken to everyone, when he cut it up, he would have pulled everything out.
Okay, yeah.
He had to be deep fried KFC alive, as per Noman swearing the oath, which I had already typed out. Not expected to be so quick. There we go. One ancestral enemy dead. More to find.
But y'all like to eat this chicken, including you, Noman, eventually, after you serve everyone. Mm-hmm. And a name pops into your head. TFC. Tribor Fried Chicken.
I would, okay, Josh, I'm sorry, but you forced my hand. So I have a party here, and they're tasting my amazing recipe. Correct?
Yes.
Would you say that everyone is thoroughly impressed with my cooking?
On a 17, yeah.
All right. Yeah. So I look to the group, and I say, all right, so we have to find this weevil fella, right?
And will not.
So, let me tell you a story. As a young gnome in the plains, you know, I just wanted to leave my mark upon the world. And that's when, you know, in the plains, you have to learn to cook whatever you can. We don't always get stuff like chicken as emotions on the plate. But you know what? There was this old gnome, 500-600 years old, white hair, and he taught me how to cook. To cook chicken with breadcrumbs and then in oil. And they called them the Colonel. So I propose that we take that 5,000 gold, we put it in to open our very first TFC, Tri-Board Fried Chicken, and we spread our brand throughout the Sword Coast, and we take the profits to fund our adventuring. What do you say? Do you like persuasion?
You know what? Sure, and you have an advantage.
That's a 15. It's not the greatest.
You know, if you guys would like to insight against that persuasion, I'll give it to you, but you don't have to. Yeah. So Craig's character is like, okay, this might be an idea, but we might also not actually get anything done.
Very skeptical.
But Sunshield and M, you're like, this guy's onto something.
We could do this, given enough resources.
You know what?
Yeah. Fallen, are you going to roll insight, or what would your character feel to this? You don't have to roll if you don't want to.
I think he would probably roll insight.
Okay.
I'm just kind of nervous about it.
Yeah, you're with Craig's character on this, like, and you both look to each other, just like very confused, like, just we won't get anything done this way. Things won't go well. But M and Sunshield, you're like, yeah, this could work.
Do they give me any counterpoints? Abilify and Silvari. We're in PvP for the rest of the session right now, guys. And it's all social.
Silvari would definitely probably end up offering over some counterpoints.
All right, so give me some. I gave you my pitch. I came up with it on the spot. This was not planned, guys. This is called role playing.
What turn did I take in this? Oh god.
I mean, here's the thing. We don't have like, so with other streams having certain sort of, you know, limits to what they can and can't, you know, they have to try and rotate through a number of
slots
a certain amount. Like, they only have X amount of weeks to run a thing. Dude, we here at Module Matchup, we enjoy our modules. Like, if this takes us the rest of the year just to play through Storm Kings, who cares? We had a great time doing it, and we went all sorts of crazy. We'll make the module ours.
Great.
Oh, whatever.
No two sessions will be alike.
Nope. So, what are your counterpoints, Abilify and Silvari?
We could totally do this. I mean, of course, we'd have to get backing from some sort of temple, and we'd have to make sure that different areas are around. And...
your temple? What? Points to your holy symbol?
Yes.
I mean, we'll need charitable donations.
We'll need buildings.
Of course, we'll but here's chickens. The thing. We need buildings, right? He looks.
And it's for rebuilding.
He's going to go one by one, right? We need buildings, right?
Yeah.
Knocks on the barn. Yeah. Our very first, and we're rebuilding Tribor. But here's the best part of this. As we expand our empire of TFC, never again will we have to pay for food or lodging, because we, in every TFC, we can put an owner's quarters and have some beds there. And now, look at that. The money you save. Done. Local communities, farmers have chickens. They won't even have to ship them far. Homegrown. We're supporting local farmers. We're all about it.
Who's going to run it while we're not?
Points to some... We'll find a few people. You know, there's always people looking to make a better life for themselves. Don't you want a better life for your family? If you have one?
I do.
Well, I mean, where does your family live? He asks. Where?
Thornhold.
Looks like we can have a good place there, and boom, they can there. There you go. We already have our very first manager. We gotta support local and families, right? Looks still Silvari.
Silvari offers up a thumbs up because this, despite that it would end up putting them horribly off. Silvari, being of a noble background, can kind of understand the ideal of it and the fact of how to be able to get these things done. He's actually already thinking about, well, if I contact this person and we talk to this person and we send a missive to this person, then we'd be able to get this resource, and the land and titles.
And looks to vilify. And it will not put us off track, because we'll just simply look to buy land and expand to where we're traveling. I mean, trying to get into, like, Neverwinter or, you know, Waterdeep, that's the goal. But, I mean, we're a brand new enterprise here. We gotta cut our teeth here in the Sword Coast.
Wouldn't the merchants put out?
No, the merchants wouldn't. So think of it this way, right? You're a merchant. You're traveling here through Tribor. There's not a lot. There's an inn. The food's okay, right? Was it better than my food?
It was. She shakes her head.
It was. No.
So you're a merchant traveling through, and there's this new kind of restaurant out here in the frontiers. You're not expecting that. So what are you going to talk about when you get back to Neverwinter, a place of luxury where there's thousands of choices, right? You're going to talk about Tribor fried chicken. And when they go through Tribor, every merchant in the Sword Coast is going to come eat in our restaurant, because it's a little bit of home here on the frontier.
Last question.
Looks back to Abilify.
what's to stop somebody else from acting and making their own?
Points to the fact that he's got a sword on his back and an axe beak.
I was hoping you were going to go for the secret formula.
I know what you were trying, but no one doesn't get that joke. But he's just like, no one can copy that, and I'll beat them up. Because that's the normal response. And he goes, and well, my entire clan's dead. That's why you see them all around me. So no one knows my recipe.
Oh, my apologies.
Yeah, they were kind of crazy.
What was your clan's name? Your name?
I'm Noman the Barbarian. Mainly the Barbarian because I'm a barbarian and I don't know my clan or last name.
Jeez.
You sold me.
God damn it!
And so Noman walks out and he... Oh god, it's Noman. He walks to the town hall. He knocks on the door. I know there's no response.
No.
Because she's dead, because I played her. He walks in, writes himself a deed to the land.
Oh,
walks no. In. It's not a forgery, there's no one to stop him, he has the seal. It's technically not a forgery, he signs it himself.
Okay.
He signs his own name.
Oh, God.
He's not trying for any forgery.
He sold it to himself from the city.
Yeah.
Puts the official stamp on it and everything.
Alright.
And he comes back and he hangs a future sign of Tribor's fried chicken on the barn.
When you hang the sign, a few random people just start asking you questions about it.
Noman takes look like a workable people, like the laborers, people that could work.
Yeah, these look like people that look like they're on a hard time, especially with what just happened. Yeah.
He asks if anyone farmers.
Like there's like about five people gathered right now. Like three of them are farmers.
Okay, so he looks at the three farmers. Homeless. Yeah, he looks at the three farmers. And says, "We're gonna need chicken."
Wow.
Motions to the sign. Oh, you're illiterate, aren't you? Tribor's fried chicken. We're gonna cook chicken and feed it to people. In a very special way. He goes, if we had more, I would... If you weren't on a deadline, I would, by all means, cook you some right now. However, if you guys could start raising chickens, we will buy them at a generous rate. As a down payment, he gives each of them 3 gold, which is more money than they make in a year.
Yeah.
I know economics.
You've told me this.
He looks to the two laborers that look homeless. This barn will provide you shelter. You can stay in here as long as you fix it up. We'll be gone for about a week. I want to see progress. And he hands them each a gold piece for, supplies, for your food, and, of course, get some ale. And,
about 2 weeks.
But he said he's going to tell them a week, so they work harder.
Okay.
While you're doing this, a sixth person goes up. He looks to be a teenager.
He asks him if... Okay, I'm sorry, but I have to do this. Teenager, what race?
Human.
He asks
him. Is his name Josh?
No.
No.
He looks. No one looks at him. Does he look like he has much of a future as anything other than either a laborer or a farmer?
He looks like he might go into a life of crime eventually if he doesn't get something.
Okay. No one looks at him. Boy, I think you have potential. What does he say back to me?
In what?
In managing people. I want to put you on a path to management in our fine chicken restaurant here.
You know what? I'm sold.
Sold? Here's the thing. Can't do a ton of work for you yet because the building still is busy. You supervise these men. Here's 5 silver pieces because you're not going to be doing much work. But when we come back, if they've done a good job, you get a bonus.
He looks to the two others that you'd probably gesture to. All right, get to work. Boss says so.
And Noman walks in because literally I just put some kid without a future in the path to management in a fast food chain. So therefore, I have won the session. You guys may take it from here.
I don't know how we got to this point, but I don't know how to feel about it.
So I'm ready to leave the town if you guys are good. Oh, do you tell Noman about the shard?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So Noman looks to everybody and goes, here's the thing. We figure that they know that it was here. Right? They came here, they knew where to dig. Now, out of character, to explain to the viewers. Well, we had the information that they had the rod. Our characters don't. So we can't act or make plans on that information. So, where Noman is going with this is the fact that he's going to say that they're still going to think it's here. He would tell the people of Tribor to bury it outside of the north, we'll say whatever direction the camera, I think it was northeast part of town. Okay, bury it kind of so that it shows. This way, should they come back, if they're coming in the same direction, they should see that and not have to push in to the town. Should save you guys the trouble, because even what you're telling me with this, you know, with your great history checks, no one explains. It's a piece to a relic that we can't use and doesn't, and we're not dragons. Last time I checked, most dragons are dicks. That would be his plan. Because there's no way we're carrying 1,000 pounds worth of that around.
So what's your plan again?
It's to bury it in closer to the where the giants came from. Valley.
Ah, okay.
This way that it's out of the town so that they don't, if they come looking for it, they should come across it first and not have to invade the town. Because no matter what, Noman is a civ, if they're coming back with more forces, they're going to go to the same spot exactly, if not level the town. And Noman and the group is now a property owner in the town. Therefore, he cares about Tribor now.
Yeah. That's a good idea. Okay.
He would also tell him to send word to, like, Neverwinter immediately. Because I think that is the closest large city. That would, yeah. Because Waterdeep will sit in council. So he would tell him to send word to Neverwinter and Helmshold to potentially get soldiers. If this has some sort of bigger play.
He's gonna kill me.
So, that is Noman's strategical thinking about the fighting.
On the road.
Thomas, back to me. Let's go.
So.
All right. Oh. I was going through my items. I have a parapet of health. I'm a paladin, so I can't get diseases anyway. But does someone want it?
No. I'm so sorry for this. Noble looks at Catherine.
Uh-huh.
You're a barbarian lass, right?
Aye.
Well, and you might need that so you can keep yourself clean. I'm so sorry.
No, you're not!
It's literally how no one views.
No.
He was raised, I'm sorry.
No, you're not! Sorry.
Noman has a super in-depth backstory, like if you guys have ever read it. Just to get out of character again, a little bit of history. Noman's tribe, women were as promiscuous as the men. Like, there was no sort of shame in it. So he's not saying it to be like a dick. He's saying it because, you know, by all means, how she's been described, Catherine is a decently attractive woman, but albeit like large and a little bit, intimidating to people. Like, she's like, if this lass is anything like the ones that I grew up with, then she's going to be everywhere every night, you know. And it's not as a slight. Because he doesn't understand the whole being ashamed. If you've ever met Noman, he doesn't hold shame. So, I mean, you can take that however you'd like, Catherine, but that's where Noman's coming with it.
Yep, I'm saying, I don't know. No, he's gonna. She's gonna like kind of look at you, kind of like. You like, kind of like put her over her chest, like where her tattoo is, and kind of like, nope, don't do it, nope. Wait. And she, I will take that though.
Okay.
Parapet of health.
She just looks to the others to see if they want it. I don't know.
That's fine with me.
Savari gives a thumbs up.
Money.
Yeah, because monks are going to be fine with that if soon enough, and
she's yeah, and mine already does it. So yeah, I figure somebody
you already
else
got
can
it,
use
yeah.
it.
Well, it's good. Yeah. Good way to share wealth.
Remind me what that does.
It's in the SRD.
It's immunity to disease.
Oh.
If you already have a disease and like you don't know it, the disease effects are suppressed while you're wearing it too. So if like you have some terrible disease and you have no idea, you're fine now.
Oh.
I think it's attunement, but I'll check.
How do you spell paraphrase?
P-R-I-P-A-T, I think.
If you search by health, it comes up.
Yeah, as we head out, I guess Noman would actually... because he's got the speed. Noman would walk, and he would offer for Axie to follow and carry, like, you know, bags and stuff to kind of lighten the load. He's not going to be carrying, like, everything, because it's an axe beat, not a weight-bearing animal, but, you know, enough where, like, we can put backpacks and bedrolls, stuff like that.
Keep the wizard in the middle, thank you, please.
Axie will flank you. How about that?
Okay.
So I guess as we set out on the road to Long Saddle, Josh, today I think that's a good point for us to kind of settle in for next session. We have created Tribor Fried Chicken. We have hired our first employees. The domination of Tribor Fried Chicken. Hold on. I need to do this, Josh. I am truly sorry, but there is one thing that just needs to happen today. Your first DMing game. I think that it's only fitting that we do something to the map, just for you. I mean, because you have been so good to us today, that if we didn't do this, this would be a terrible, terrible thing. You know, the rest of you agree with me, right? We should give Josh an honorary thing today on the map.
Oh, honors of Josh.
Okay, good. I'm glad you all agree, because I was going to do it either way. Because that's who I am. Oh, that's not what I wanted to do. Let's see. Reloads. Maybe I cannot... maybe I have to do it through the DM screen. But you guys totally know what I'm about to do. Those of you watching on stream. You see it? Did you see it?
Subliminal marketing. Deluxe called it.
It is totally subliminal marketing. So, you know, if you're watching and you happen to work for KFC, by all means, hit me up on Mixer. There's a Twitter link down below. Join our Discord. We can talk deals. You know, I know that Firefly really loves chicken.
I do.
So
I'm rather a fan, too.
You know, the only person who doesn't have one too close is probably me. So that being said, I mean, totally, you don't even have to pay us money. You know, send us some coupons as we totally bring you, you know, only
you
the
experience
best.
Experience the world.
Uploading image.
Doing so.
There's the kernel.
All right.
I like our marker.
No, that's not our marker.
Ah, is that our franchise?
I am going to put our franchises all over the map.
I love it.
We've started our first franchise.
Thank you, Josh.
Thank you.
Is there any, before we end tonight's stream, going into Critical Role over on Twitch, Is there any? By the way, any artists out there, if you do us like a mock-up gnome TFC, I will change the icon. You can submit them on the Discords. We will totally use your art and give you credit for it all over Twitter and the stream. That being said, is there any other questions that you guys have for us today in chat? Before we let you go, this is kind of the perfect time. A little Q&A before the end.
I regret everything.
Don't worry about anything, dude. Here's the thing. All right, Josh, would you like a barometer on your performance?
I also had fun. I'm not just saying that.
No, but would you like a barometer on your performance? Hey, did everyone hear minus Sparts, who doesn't get a vote because he either slept or went to the store or forgot that he wasn't connected the entire session? Does anyone have a? Did anyone have fun? Yeah, there he goes. Hey, Sparts.
It was great.
Hey, Sparts. So you didn't get a vote in this, but we've started a franchise that we're gonna spread across. It's called Tribor Fried Chicken.
Let's do it.
No, seriously, we've already decided to do it.
Let's do it.
So, is there any other? Did everyone have fun today?
Yeah, I did. I can't wait to hear Josh run.
Hi, Josh. Josh, fun. Then you did your job. Chad, did you guys have fun? TFC slogan. We're gonna take actual. We might use the actual KFC slogan. If not, we'll think about it. And we might come up with our own. But we'll definitely field some ideas this week. But that being said, it's about 10 minutes to 10. We thank you guys all in chat. Thank you to the players. Thank you to Josh for running your first game here on actual stream for us. You did well, kid.
I
we look forward to it next week. This is now Tribor Fried Chicken's Thunder. But that being said, goodbye to everyone. Say goodbye to Mixer.
Bye, Mixer.
See you guys.
Bye, Mixer.
Thanks, guys. We will see you next week here on Storm King's Thunder, Learn to Play, the Module Mashup Series at 8 p.m. Thursday, running to about Critical Role. All right, guys. Have a great night.